Hello, I'm James Schweitzer with Corelight, and I'm here to talk about how we can illuminate lateral movement in your network, specifically related to scheduled tasks. Corelight sensors run the Zeek network security monitor, formerly known as Bro. And throughout the past 15 years, it's really become the definitive tool for parsing network traffic in real time. You can think of it as a flight recorder, where it's providing better data to allow for faster event resolution. Now, this data can be used to assist in threat detection within your network, but it's important to understand that its threat detection is art and science, and that there's no silver bullet. But what there is rich contextual data. And we'll start by talking about a recent article in the MTrends 2018, where it mentioned that hidden threats remain in legacy systems. And specifically in this use case, or the case study, I want to focus on the internal reconnaissance that was performed by the adversary using the Windows Task Scheduler. If you're unfamiliar about the use of scheduled tasks, the attack.mitre.org model provides a great explanation of how scheduled tasks can be used to maintain persistence and also be executed as part of lateral movement. There are several adversaries that have made use of scheduled tasks for quite a while. But what you're really interested in is detection. Wouldn't it be great to have a system, a security sensor, that parsed the protocols, provided you identification for workstations and users? That's where Corelight sensors can assist in detecting lateral movement. You can look in your analytic platform and search for the IT task scheduler service. If you've had scheduled tasks be executed, you're going to see responses come back from your analytic platform. Let's take those analytic platforms and let's select a unique identifier field from Bro and see if we can pivot and dig in. When we look at that single session, we'll see that we have several different logs that are related. We start with our connection log. In the con log, the first thing that you'll notice is that the two devices communicated with IP version 6. You'll also see that hostname resolution occurs and how that resolution was learned. In this case, it was from a DNSA record. The next step, so when you see the NTLM log, what it's going to provide is hostname resolution in addition to the username that was used for accessing or completing the scheduled task event. In this case, it's the administrator. When we look at the final piece of this tied together through the unique identifier, what we'll see when we look at the DCE RPC log is the operation that was performed. And if you start, the first is the negotiation between the RPC version, tasks were enumerated, and then a task was scheduled. Corelight sensors parse dozens of network protocols and provide context-rich logs that link sessions with unique identifiers. I hope this brief video demonstrated to you how Corelight sensors can be used to locate lateral movement related to scheduled tasks within your network. Thank you.